everybody. This is Praxis, and you can see I'm in the lower field that's kind of away from the house. I'm here today because it's raining today. There's really not that much carpentry that I can do. I can probably bang together a few posts, but my post work is pretty much done. What I really need to be working on right now is decking, and the decking is the worst thing to do when it's wet. So I want to still use the time that I've got, and one thing that I've been wanting to do, but I've been focusing on that because the day's been good for it, is to grab some of this great grass that just naturally grew down in this area. This area was cleared out for the leach field, which is going to go right behind you, back by that little white pipe area. It's going to come down from the house. This is our septic sort of management area that processes all that. And pretty soon, all this area is going to get torn up by the excavators. And this grass, it just kind of grew here when they cleared out the area. It's a nice grass. It only grows to be about like 2 inches tall or so. It's soft. I think it's kind of pretty. It's not homogeneous. There's all different types of grasses mixed in. And you know, if you've ever had any experience with history, having homogeneous crops tends to be not that great of a thing. It's good to have kind of a mix. It just keeps the biodiversity up, and it keeps one kind of disease or pest from like going through and wiping out an area. So it's just a great mix, and it's all stuff that's indigenous to this area right here. And especially the fact that it only grows to be a couple of inches tall. You know, if everyone planted their lawn with this, and granted, everyone wouldn't work because people live in different areas, but if everyone in this area planted their lawn with this, they'd never have to mow their lawn. So many of the things that we take for granted as a given in our society, it's like, well, everyone has to mow their lawn. Not necessarily. If you planted your lawn with grass that grows to be just the right height to be comfortable to walk on, then you wouldn't have to mow your lawn. So I want to steal as much of this as I can before it gets destroyed by the earth movers coming down in here. Now, I did put seed up there, just to try to hold the soil and everything. But if I can get this stuff mixed in with that stuff, and over time, since this stuff is indigenous and it likes being in this area, maybe this stuff will kind of retake over that area up there. So I'm just coming down here and grabbing shovelfuls. And I'm going to spread it up top. If you've ever played Minecraft, and if you saw the day 3 episode where I go through the Minecraft simulation of this house here, you know that I have on occasion. And what I'm pulling up, if you're a fan of Minecraft, is grass blocks. So my thought is I'll be pulling up grass blocks, and then they'll just spread, just like they do in Minecraft and in real life. Because, the seeds will come out from these guys, and hopefully just kind of reseed the yard. Looks like there's little strawberry plants in here too. I'm just kind of going around the periphery. I want to get a few inches of soil under here. All right, got one more side to snip. There's a few rocks under here, but overall it's been pretty easy. There we go. And it's a Minecraft grass block. I don't think I could carry 64 of them in one hand though. You only get that if you played Minecraft. That's it. Thanks for watching.